Welcome everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week we're going to do our face in the forest tutorial, and we're going to start off with this picture here on the screen. And the first thing we're going to do is make a selection just of the face here. So let's come over here to our selection brush tool, make our brush fairly big, and let's just make a selection of the face here. So we just want just the face, which is fine, and maybe a little bit of the hair here as well. So we've got our selection. Let's come up here to refine, and let's just go over these little bits here and these little bits down here, making our brush a little bit smaller using our right and left bracket keys, and just down the side here. So that looks pretty good. Let's just smooth that by 4 and feather it by 4, and let's on our output here choose new layer and apply. And it'll give us just the face of our picture here on a new layer with a transparent background. So on our new layer here, let's add a mask and click on our mask here. So once we've clicked on our mask, let's invert the mask with a command I, and it'll disappear, but it's still there underneath, just inverted. I'm going to grab my brush tool, come over here to my brushes. And on the bottom here, I've downloaded these brushes here, the tree brushes, and I've got those from Brusheezy, and I'll link that below. And I'm going to pick this tree here, and I'm going to make that quite big. Going to make sure my color is white because I've got my mask inverted. I'm just going to come over here to my picture, and you can see when I put it up, part of the picture starts appearing. I'm just going to use my tree and just go around and put that, paint some of those branches onto my model here. So I'm just going to go around. I'm using my arrow keys down the bottom here to move this tree around. Just going to keep moving it, paint that in, and move the tree all the way around, paint some more in. And just keep moving the tree and going around, bringing back some of our model here. So all the way around of our model. Then I'm going to make my tree a little bit smaller and get my eyes in here. And a little bit smaller and get some of this nose. Make sure I get the mouth. I'm going to turn the tree all the way around. And I'm just going to fill some of that in with the tree. And that's not looking too bad, all around here. So what we're going to do once we're happy with what we've done with our tree brush here, we're going to click on our model with the mask and go Command C. Going to come over here to our other picture, which is the picture of the forest. I might just go Command minus and make that a little bit smaller. And then Command V to paste our model in. So let's grab our move tool and just move our model into place. And I'm thinking I want it so the mouth is sort of on that path there. So I'm just going to click about there in the middle. We can always move it a little bit later. So on the model layer here, I'm going to change the blend mode. I'm going to change the blend mode to darken. You can see it's already started to blend our model or our person into the trees there. So the next thing I'm going to do is add an adjustment. I'm going to come down here to our adjustments, and I'm going to add a black and white. And just on the red channel here, I'm going to bring the red channel down a fair bit, probably about minus 35, and maybe bring the yellow channel up a tiny bit, maybe 159. Okay, I'm going to click off that. Also going to add a levels adjustment. So back to our adjustments, and I'm going to click on levels. I'm going to clip the levels just to our model layer here. So I'm going to click on the levels, bring it down and just clip it just so it affects the model. And I'm going to play with some of these sliders here. I'm going to bring the gamma down a little bit, got about 719 there. I'm going to bring the black slider up slightly, and the output white I'll bring down a little bit just to get some of that detail in. and about 5% on the output black. So we started to get it sort of blended in a little bit better. So let's click off our levels now. I'm going to click back on my mask, back to my brushes, and I just want a regular soft brush now. So a nice soft brush. Grab our paintbrush again. Make my brush fairly big, and I'm going to make sure my paintbrush is on black. My opacity is 100, my flow I've got down at 25%, and I'm just going to get rid of some of these areas here. Going to make my brush quite small, just sort of paint that path in a little bit there. Make my brush a little bit bigger, and I'm going to drop the opacity down a little bit more. I think I'll go about 50. Now and make my brush fairly big, and I'm just going to click in these areas where you can see sort of some of that skin left over there and down the side here. Make my brush a little bit smaller and just put some of those branches back into these details, some over the eyes here, and we're just putting some of those branches back in. Get rid of some of that. I'm just painting around now. Some of those branches back in, just where some of that skin is showing through on the nose here as well. We want our model to look like they're really hidden in part of these trees. And just keep going around. We still don't want to lose too much detail either. So some in the eyes there. Okay, might have gone a little bit too far. If you go too far, just remember you can hit X on your keyboard and bring some of that back. Okay, what I'm going to do now is just grab my dodge tool, and I'm going to click on just the model layer here. I'm going to bring some of that white back in her eyes. Click around, bringing some of that white detail back. And also I'm going to change to my burn tool as well, and just maybe burn some of that darker areas in around the eyes here. And on the nose here, just building that darker area back in. And on the lips as well, some of that dark back in. The eyes, I think we might need a little bit more dodging on the white areas to make them stand out a little bit. Pretty good. We've got it blended fairly well. So the last thing I'm going to do is just add a curve. So I'm just going to come down to curves. I want the curves layer all the way on top so it affects everything. I'm just going to grab the middle here and just drag the middle down. Make that a little bit darker. Sort of a little S curve. Looking pretty good. Probably do a little bit more work on the nose there. So let's grab our brush back again. Make sure we're on our black and on the mask here, and we'll just bring some of those trees back in on the nose and lips there and through here. Still sort of keeping the shape there, and I'm happy with that, guys. So there we go. That is our face in the forest tutorial using our picture of our model and our tree brush from Brushies, and also the picture of the forest here. Don't forget, if you just want to click on your model here and grab your move tool, you can just move that around a little bit just to get it a little bit straighter. And you can play around a lot more with a lot more of the detail. So there we go, everybody. That's the tutorial for this week, blending our face into the forest. I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial this week. If you have, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, and please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I will say to you, stay safe, stay well, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.